If you are new to the channel, I would love to have you as a subscriber. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe and hit that button so we can vibe it out. We'll see what the day comes. There's really no structure to this. We're just going to go with the flow. But today's errands, structuring out Christmas gifts, all that good stuff.
These are great gifts for kids or just... Because you know, sometimes you just need a couple random gifts in case something were to come out. The T-Rex. These are great gifts, sensory, especially with little children. I mean, this is stuff that you want. Stimulates them. I used to make my own DIYs with Malachi. What else is over here? Come over here. Walk, walk, walk. A fireman set. What is that? Oh, that's cool for 3 and up for your little cousins. I like all these learning toys. Stocking stuffers.
Let's go to the next one.
You can never go wrong with the classic tractor. And then tools. Oh, look at these. Those are cool.
So right now, Five and Below has a bunch of little random Christmas shirts,
plush pajamas, sweats, wrapping paper. If you don't know this about me, well, you're gonna learn. I absolutely love wrapping paper. I like to do wrapping paper more than bags. I just feel like, especially with the kids being so little. Yeah, bows. A lot of great stuff right now. You know, I'm going to do my own gift guide set, but if you are trying to get something small for something and you don't want to spend a lot, this is a great budget. You get a mug, you get a treat, you wrap it up with some clear saran wrap and add a bow, and you have a Christmas gift. It doesn't have to be crazy expensive. It's simple. Add a candy cane to your touch.
And we got gingerbread houses.
You know what? These are really great educational workbooks. I just bought some for Malachi. I think probably by January, I'm going to start buying him the grade one. And these are just great. Literally for any time. There's so many. Inexpensive. Like, all my curriculum for kindergarten, I literally got at the 99 cent store and Dollar Tree. Ooh, if you got an abuelita, bam, get her one of these. Can't be $5. Come on, you buy a bunch of gifts for like under $50. Come on, Pops, let's see what else is over here.
Let's see this over here. They have shoes.
You can never go wrong for slippers for anybody as a gift ever. If I get Crocs, my husband said he'll divorce me. So when he gets mad, I'm like, I'm gonna get Crocs. Five and Below is so lit. There are so many great things right now. I want to show these. These are really great. LA Girl Cosmetics. I love their makeup and it's also cruelty free. So for those who don't want to spend on it, these are just as good. Oh, these are good too. You want to do a lazy manicure? So I only have a couple girlfriends I'm actually getting a few things for. And I like to do little stocking stuffers, but this really intrigued me. This is all natural, like eye serum, face oils, all that good stuff. I have to read the ingredients and it's infused with real flowers. The stuff is really good. Like, they've really upped their game. And look at all this makeup. Lashes. What are these? Longer bolder. You know, I might get this for myself today because I actually have no mascara. So my sister wears a lot of makeup too, so I'm gonna get her a bronzer. Yeah, we're gonna get a bronzer for my sister. I'm gonna put in her gift. Oh, hold on. I know. And then even this looks cute. Girl power. And then it gives you a sample of the eyeshadows. I don't know who I would give that to, but these little ones are really beneficial. There's like no more in here, but this one really intrigues me. I think I'm gonna get this one for myself because I really want purple. I have too many nudes, so I might get these for my girlfriends since she is a stay-at-home mom. These are like coconut balms. These are infused oils. I'm trying to try this for her. It'd be a great gift.
I love me some LA Girl lipsticks. I don't even know if I should, but this is pretty.
I stopped buying expensive mascaras, so I'm gonna grab me a couple of these too. Black. Get rid of these.
Get my candy.
Cute little shirt. My girlfriend just lost a lot of weight recently, and I'm like, I gotta get her something cute to wear. These are great to put in there, little random wipes. Yeah, I think I'm gonna get a couple of these. Like, we need candy. You know what's crazy? A fun fact is my son does not like candy. He just plays with it. I mean, which is a good thing, but you know. Yep, I need some popcorn. We found some. We got little toys in them. So we're just about done. We're gonna check out and we'll show you guys what we got. Excited for some of these. All right, Malachi. Tell the nice lady which one you want. Let's see which one.
I
want to
get a donut at the back.
I know. Okay, you tell me which one you want. These are what we came for. And then, do you want the chocolate or the maple bar?
The chocolate.
And then a chocolate bar, please. So we are back at the crib. I thought I'd lay it out so you could see what I picked up. I picked up some bows for gifts. You couldn't beat this. I got a gang of tape over here. I opened one, but I just wanted to show you. I put it back, but I had no mascara. LA Curls colors. If you are looking for reasonable, inexpensive mascara, and a girl ain't got no eyelashes, this is good. I also picked up some lipsticks. This is actually going to be for a stocking stuffer. Their makeup is so... People, do not sleep on Five and Below. Just don't. It's not even worth it. Yeah, but these are all going to be stocking stuffers. I think I bought this one for me. I have to go through. I be buying stuff and I'm just like, who did I buy this for? Some tissue paper for my little perrita Santa baby. Some paint, of course, for Malachi. And again, I'm doing stocking stuffers. So I bought some of these. I'm going to put like makeup, whatever I come across, cosmetics. I bought this for an actual stocking stuffer for my girlfriend. She doesn't really wear a lot of makeup, but I thought this was really nice and I love the packaging. Then I bought this for myself. This is a 3x longer Bolder Lashes, a mascara trio set. So, and clearly I'm gonna get on camera right now and you see, I ain't got no eyelashes. Like, I got none. None. That's why I glue mine on. I told y'all I got no eyelashes. This is why I glue my eyelashes on. Granted, I'm comfortable with my skin not having to wear a lot of makeup. I just wear makeup because, you know, sometimes I just want to be in that mood, you know? I just want to be like, I'm that girl. But really, 80% of the time, I look like this. But I wanted to show real quick what I got at Five and Below. I did go to the 99 cent store. I'm just going to film that separately. I spent like $145 at the 99 cent store. And you're probably like, how could you spend $145? It's easy. It's easy, especially when you're doing stuff for Christmas like me. I ended up getting gifts for other kids. I always buy miscellaneous gifts too, especially with the holidays coming up, because we always adopt different children. Just this year, we actually ended up adopting two, because last year, because of COVID, they didn't do any adoption. So we actually picked two children. Sometimes we'll just buy it for a family. It really just depends. So I'm going to change and get into something comfy. I want to speak this. Just hopefully it can hit somebody from the heart and just know... Toxic family is real. There's nothing wrong with protecting your peace, but let's change and get comfy. And we're gonna catch a vibe before we close out this video. Okay, so we comfy. Did you get you a drink? Did you get some tea? Did you get you a soda? Did you get some water? I'm drinking water because I'm underhydrated. I don't know what it is, but this weather just, I suck at drinking water from like November to January. It just sucks. But anyways, where do I start? I went 7 years and didn't start talking to my sister until recently. And I know some people are just like, oh my gosh, like how could you not talk to your sibling? Also, I don't have a relationship with my father. And I've had a rocky road for the last few years with my mother. Granted, my family is very broken. And I decided to step away from everybody and accept my role. Not just as a black sheep, but just as me, as an Adriana. And I feel like a lot of people get caught up with toxicity. And
this may sound even more harsh, but I also do believe that we can bring on our own karma. And I know some people are like, well, what are you saying? Like, it's my fault that I got cancer. It's my fault that I lost my job. It's my fault. No, I'm not saying to that extreme. But at the end of the day, I really do believe how we treat people, it comes back to us. But the last several years have been very difficult because, you know, I feel like when I got married, it's like I had this vision of what I thought my life would have been like. It turned out to be the complete opposite, that it was so foreign to me that I didn't even know how to comprehend it, let alone work through it and figure it out. For years, I had people that would always be coming to me if I went to a family function. My new family functions were already divided as it was. And they would always come up to me just like, you know, why aren't you talking to your sister? Why aren't you talking to this? Oh my gosh, your sister really needs you. What about your dad? How's your dad doing? And it's just like, clearly y'all know I don't talk to them. But it's like they need some type of fuel to figure out what it is. I cannot tell you how many times I'd walk into a family barbecue with so much anxiety and just PTSD, just like, just preparing. And it shouldn't be that way, especially if you're going to a function. If I'm going to go to a barbecue, if I'm going to go to a get together, I shouldn't feel this pressure of anxiety to defend myself, but that's the way it's been. And there's so many people out there that battle this, that struggle with this, and who get shamed for it. Now, here's my thing. My sister and my father have very similar qualities. They're not very good at apologizing. They're not very good at owning accountability to what they can do wrong. And I'm here, let me tell you right now, I recently just reconnected with my sister this February of 2021. First time, full throttle. We've been acquainted, but we have not had no relationship. And it also happened at a funeral. My grandmother, my last grandmother just passed away this past year. I lost 7 people in a matter of a few months, maybe like less than 90 days. Going to back-to-back funerals was mentally just draining, but also it was very emotionally unhealthy because I felt like I was struggling with the grieving process. And I grieve differently than other people. I'm not here to judge anybody how they grieve. But for me, it just felt like it wasn't enough time in between. So my sister and I ended up rekindling. She actually asked, like, hey, can I hold your son while I give the eulogy for, you know, our grandmother? And I said, yes, of course. Mind you, I don't hate her. I just wish she could take accountability for the things that she said that she hurt me with in the past. And like I said, I don't want to go too deep into it. I just want to go through a gist. And I'll go into my father's. But going back into this whole recent, what happened this past year. She goes up there to the gravesite and she's talking. And she starts breaking down. And Malachi's right there just really being a great support system. After my sister did her speech and whatnot, I felt this tug on my heart. And I said, yo, I don't know what you got going on today, but there's obviously no get together afterwards. Do you want to go out to dinner? All of us, you know, my family, your significant other, whoever. And she was just like, no, it's cool. And I was like, all right, cool. Like I tried. And my mother was always getting in the middle too, just like, you guys need to talk. You guys need this. But I'm like, you need to understand where I'm coming from. And two, here's the thing. I knew I was struggling with some type of daddy issues because I had some anger and I was very savage and ruthless, not just with just people, but just with myself. I was very self-destructive, especially in my 20s. I was living a very fast, reckless life. I mean, if I got caught doing the things I was doing, I probably could have been locked up, straight up, but I didn't care. I didn't care. I did what I had to do to survive. I will say this, that day, my mother saw that I tried. I extended her olive branch and she denied me. So we come back. We end up getting drive-thru. We get burgers. I don't remember where we got these burgers. We got burgers and fries because I was like, it was a long day. You know, funerals are just exhausting. There was no like after like get together with food. So we were hungry. I have a freaking 4-year-old at the time. So we go get food. We come back to the house. We're chilling. We're eating. Out of nowhere, ding dong. And I'm like, who's at the door? Like, it ain't UPS. It was my sister and my mom. They had boxes of food. Tacos, nachos, burritos, arroz, frijoles. Like, you name it. They brought a gang of food. Mind you, like, it's just us three at the crib with the dog. So I'm like, I don't know who's coming over. So they brought all this food and we start hanging out, socializing. We start talking about my grandma. You know, my grandma had a very torturous death, in my opinion. Her son, the way she went out, was just didn't sit well with me. And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter how many kids you have. There's always one that's going to go more above than the others. That's just my opinion. It's really rare, I think, when they all can come together. But from what I've experienced, from what I've seen, there's always just that one. It's always the one that's not the favorite that's like literally pulling the weight. That's just from what I've seen on my side. Because the favorites, let's just say some of her favorites didn't even show up to the funeral, but that's a whole nother cup of tea, girl. Or gentleman. So my sister comes in. So we're eating, we're mingling. And something told me, I was just like, yo, do you want to go upstairs and like talk? I was nervous though. My heart was racing. Mind you, we haven't been cool in 7 years. I'm 35. The last time I've chilled with her on a one-on-one, I was 29 years old. Yeah. Yeah, I was 29 years old. And she didn't come to my wedding. I didn't want her at my wedding. She wasn't allowed in my baby shower. None of that. We did not have no relationship. And when people hear that, I feel like too, they just think like you're cold and you're mean. But it's so much deeper. Remember, you got to push me and to certain people to get to that level. But when you get to a level where you really protect and you love yourself and you want to protect your peace and your energy and just what you have as a person, it doesn't matter who that person is. Like, you're just not going to want it around you. But that's where I was at. So going back, we go upstairs. We're in my closet. Closet meaning the other bedroom. And we're talking. And I just wanted her to say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for hurting you. That's all I wanted her to say. But she didn't. She's just like my father. She was like, you know, pretty much, I want to just start over. Clean slate, whoop doo doo ah. And I knew I wasn't going to get that apology, but, you know, I was still hoping for it. But at the end of the day, it's water on the bridge. And even going to therapy, too. Sometimes you just got to forgive them for yourself. You got to free yourself. And see, I don't like to hold grudges. Even to people who've done me grimy. That could be another video if you really want to know. You can comment below because I've been done grimy. I've had thousands of dollars taken from me. You know, my car's been taken by people that were my friends. Like, I've been through the ringer. I'll just say that. I've been through the ringer. I've helped out girls that have been beaten by dudes, by their boyfriends, but yet they'll leave me and they'll go back to them. Like, I've been done grimy. But as heavy and as ugly those situations are, I can't change who I am as a person. Like, I can't. You know, like, I have so much love in my heart. And sometimes I'm just like, why'd you make me like this? Why? You know? And I always say too, I was like, damn, my kid's softening me up. Like I'm an emotional gangster. I'm just a passionate person. But going back to the room, I remember she, you know, when she said that, she's like, I just want to start over. And I'm like, we can start over. And she got emotional. She was showing some emotion. I know she's been broken down. I know she's been through situations too. I know her life has took her to some different places. You know, and I don't wish ill will on her or nobody. So we started over. Kind of started hanging out, getting to know each other. Because we're two different people. We are two opposites. I'm a social butterfly. I'll talk to anybody. I'm with it. I'm down to, I mean, I would leave the country with people I barely met back in the day. Like, I was wildin'. She's more just like, I don't know you. I don't know what your vibe is. Or it's like a stank face. Like, she's just, and that's just who she is. Like, that's who she is. I'm not like that. You know, I got married in less than 90 days. And she's just like, girl, you psycho. You crazy. But that's just the way I am. Like, if I feel it in my heart, I'm going to take the leap of faith. I'll move across the country. I'll stay. I don't care. But that's my breed. And that's why everybody's just like, you're wild and crazy. Because I'm full of life and passion. I'm not afraid to take that leap. And a lot of people are. Safe is boring to me. But that's just me. But what used to irritate me too is like I would go to family functions and they always would bring up my sister, just like, oh, you know, are you talking to your sister yet? Or like, your sister really needs you. And then once me and her started talking, of course they got back to the family and certain relatives. Whenever I'd see them, I hate how they would come to me and they'd be like, it's so good that you're talking to your sister again because she really needed you. And I'm just like, y'all don't even know what I've been through. Like, I've struggled. I've been by myself. I live a very military life. I had a baby that damn near died that was dead for what, less than 3 minutes? Like, I went through my own situations, my own struggles. We had no help. We didn't have this whole, like, oh my gosh, like, welcome the baby. You know, oh, you need to sleep. Oh, we're going to stay here for a couple days. Help. No, I didn't do it. I didn't get any of that. Mm-mm. It was straight survivor mode. I didn't know what I was doing. You know, my husband had to work. It was a very lonely, lonely journey. And looking back on it, as much as those days were long and I felt scared and I was depressed, I didn't get anxiety until I had a baby, because I didn't know. I did have postpartum. It wasn't severe, but I was just in a really dark place. Didn't want to ever harm my baby, but I was just so protective of him because of what I went through with him. Flashing forward to my dad. You know, my dad and I have always had a up and down relationship. I don't hate him. I don't think he's an evil person, but I feel like I wish he would connect more emotionally. My dad blocks a lot of his feelings, you know, and I feel like he's better being expressive with other people and his stepchildren versus his own biological children. But that's just me. So there's always been this void, and I've always wanted a great relationship with him. So when I lost my grandfather when I was a teenager, that hit me hard, because my grandfather was seriously like a second dad to me. My grandpa was everything to me. My grandpa, and you know, like I said, my dad was always a provider, but he wasn't emotionally connected with me. He wasn't. Even the things I would talk about, it was just very commercial. It never connected. Mind you, he's still alive, and I don't wish anything on him. I know he has his own battles right now. He has his own family. He has his own stepkids. He has his own everything. But I know my place with him. If this hits somebody, just hear me out. If this hits somebody, if you've tried and you've expressed how you feel with certain relatives, especially with the holidays coming up, because how many of us get invited to little, it could be certain gatherings, it could be dinners, it could be maybe you have an annual, what is it, ugly sweater party. Like, there's all kinds of things now. There's all kinds of whatever. If you don't feel comfortable going, don't go. If you have that annoying, obnoxious tia that's just not happy with herself, but she's always in everybody else's cheesement, don't go. Don't ever let anybody make you feel otherwise when it comes to your feelings. Like, that's your truth. And I used to let others overpower that. Just like, well, maybe they're right. You know, this person is my auntie. This person is my uncle. That is my sister, whatever. But as I got older and when I went to therapy and I started really connecting the dots with myself, no, you don't have to subject yourself to anybody when it comes to that. Toxic is toxic. Doesn't matter. Blood or not, it's still not healthy. And I know there's some people that enjoy it. I know there's some people that feel like, well, you know, I have to tolerate it. And it's just become so repetitive in their behavior. You don't have to deal with it. You don't. And I've just learned to love from afar. I've learned to just accept my place. And you can love them from a distance. You can keep them at arm's length. You can also walk into an environment. You're like, you know, I want to go to Theo, you know, Jimmy's house and, you know, enjoy Christmas. You can go. You can be cordial and say what's up to people. Hey, how you doing? Oh, hey, you know, whatever. You don't got to chill with any of them. But you get to take control of that situation. But I had a lot of enablers. Why aren't you helping dad? Why aren't you helping so-and-so? Oh, did you hear that they're collecting money for so-and-so? Where was everybody at when I didn't have a freaking car? Where was people at when I got kicked out? Where was all that? You know, like, I had my own struggles. And it's not like poor me, victim. It's not any of that mentality either. They like to put the light on those that are favored. Call it how I see it. You know, before I got married, going back with my father, I had some things I really wanted to get off my chest when I went to therapy. And I was about 25 when I went to therapy, 26. And I remember the therapist was like, hey, this is a great exercise. Try to open up the tables of communication and say what you feel on what you would like to hear, like of an apology or being something receptive with the topic. So I remember I was so nervous and I took the initiative. I was just like, hey, dad, do you want to go have breakfast? And he was like, yeah, sure. So we go to this little hole in the wall, little Mexican spot, and we go get breakfast and we're chilling. I haven't sat with my dad one-on-one, I can't tell you, maybe like 8 years. Literally one-on-one and had like
a conversation with him. And bottom line is he just doesn't want it. He doesn't want it. But that day I did, you know, I was just like, hey, I forgive you with the things that you did wrong. Something in those in that nature with those words. And he didn't acknowledge it. He just kind of swept it under, like, kind of like the way my sister would say. She's just like, well, you know, pretty much, I hope you feel better. Like, you know, sorry you felt that way. I'm sure we've all heard that term, right? It was pretty much in those words. Once I heard that, I was like the therapist says, she was like, you just got to take it, digest it, accept what you can't change, and forgive yourself. Well, forgive them for you, like, to let it go. That's what I did. And these exercises really helped me as I move forward. And there's a lot of people in my family that have struggles. And I know they don't have the healthiest relationships. I know some people shame therapy, like, you know, something's wrong with you. But I really was in a dark place. And my family, I feel like they don't want to talk about certain things. We can't talk about the birds with the bees. Like, you know what I'm saying? We can't talk about certain topics. And I just don't understand. And I knew for a fact when I got pregnant, I remember just even when I got pregnant, I would hold my stomach. I was like, I don't ever want you to go through the emotional struggle that I felt growing up. You know, even for me, I have those days where I lash or I feel like I mess up or I'm too hard on him or I let my anger get the best of me or my frustration, you know, especially battling what's going on politically in this world. You know, I feel like I'm taking on all these bullets, you know, and I can only take so many and sometimes I'm wounded. But I even go to him just like, Papa, I'm so sorry. I was hard on you today. I'm sorry I yelled at you the way I did. Can you forgive me? Mommy, I love you. To be different, you gotta break the cycle. And it's gonna feel weird and it's gonna hurt. But you have the power. So to anybody that watches this video and you feel like you're alone and you feel like nobody can understand your struggles with your demons, you're not alone. But you're going to have to fight through them. You can't rely on anybody that's going to hold your hand to pull through. You have to do it for yourself. I fought to be the woman that I am today, which is why I feel like I get the side eye a lot. You know, oh, she's a conservative and she's homeschooling her kid. But look at how she dresses. You see the way she's wearing? How old does she think she is? I don't care. This is your life. You need to live your truth in whatever aspect that is. You need to move how you want to move. But most importantly, only allow those people that truly deserve access to you. Because not everybody deserves access to you. You are a privilege. You are a prize. See, I look at my self-worth and my self-love and my heart to that. So when I make time for those certain people, even for me, when it comes to even just certain friends, I make effort for at least one person a week. I don't care if it's just a coffee date. I don't care if it's us just getting some quick food at a drive-thru and sitting at a park just dishing. You got to free yourself. So for the holidays coming up, I know Thanksgiving just passed. Thanksgiving was a one to remember for us because it was very different. But that's another story. And it has a lot to do with, I have a nephew that came back from the military and we don't know what's going to happen with this Biden administration, but there is some things cooking that I feel like that's scary that's coming and we need to be ready as Americans. And I'm so glad we got to celebrate it the way we did. Even though under the different circumstances, but that's a whole different story. But with Christmas, with New Year's, don't feel like you have to go to certain family functions and parties and whatever because your mom or your aunt or your sibling or somebody's in your ear like, well, you have to be there. You don't have to be there. If it's causing stress on you in any type of way, you do not have to be there. Can you do that this year? Can you do something different? If you want to just stay home and have a small holiday get together for yourself, shoot, even just invite a couple friends, it doesn't matter. I mean, for the last several years, my mom was juggling going to my sister's and then coming over here. But But I had to stand my ground. And I'm really glad I did. Because now they see how I operate. Respect is earned. Okay? It's not just given out to anybody like, oh, well, that's your uncle. You have to go do it. No, you don't. That's your dad. So? That's your grandpa. And? If they ain't paying my bills and helping me and doing what I gotta do with my kid and my family, I really don't care. So take care of you this season. Don't feel any pressure from anybody. But I really hope this video brings some type of light and peace, and just know that you're not alone. You know, there's no such thing as a perfect family or a relationship or any of that. And like I said, and this is for me, like I can't align with people that are just like trying to put family to be so perfect and just, I don't know. I don't know who that is, because I've never seen it. Show it to me. Brady Bunch even had issues. But that's pretty much what I wanted to say in this video, just to give you my truth, a little bit more about me and my struggles. And I really hope this brings some light to somebody. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I know it was kind of short. It's kind of random. I was going to show a little bit more, but I feel like this really needed to be said, especially with the holiday season coming up. And I really hope you do what's best when it comes to you and taking care of you and your mental health and protecting your peace, because you are worth it on so many levels. So until the next video, you guys, I'll catch you on the next one.